ICTs can play essential roles in delivering innovative, integrated, and cross-sectoral sustainable development outcomes. With the COVID-19 pandemic, the importance of ICT has been highlighted more than ever. The call for efforts to strengthen critical infrastructure's resilience and help social and economic development has been increasing. And amid this rapid ICT development and the evolution to the digital era, trust has emerged as one of the most salient values. I am Jaesop Lee, a candidate for the Deputy Secretary General of ITU. I sincerely hope you and your families are in good health and good spirits. My vision as a candidate for the Deputy Secretary General of ITU is building a trusted ICT platform for people. At the coming PP22, the new ITU leadership will be elected for the next 4 years, and the team will bridge the following 4 years until 2030. As you well know, the year 2030 is the target year for the Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, set by the United Nations. The SDGs are the crucial targets for all UN organizations, definitely for ITU as well. I believe that ICTs make significant contributions to all 17 goals, particularly good health, quality education, gender equality, industry innovation and infrastructure, sustainable cities, climate actions, and many others. ITU's three sectors, ITUR, ITUT, and ITUD, are actively engaging in those areas. Therefore, I believe that the three sectors should continue their efforts to achieve the relevant SDG goals. As a candidate for Deputy Secretary General, I'm particularly focusing on Goal 17, Global Partnerships. The General Secretariat of ITU, led by the Secretary General's collaborative efforts with the three sectors, should focus on cooperation among UN organizations, member states, and private sectors. For me, one of the most critical challenges for ensuring such global partnerships is how to build trusted relationships. WISIS is an important platform to address this endeavor for all stakeholders, administrations, regulators, industries, academia, and civil societies. As the director of TSB, I exerted my efforts to implement WISIS action lines by sharing our technical knowledge and the experts of ITUT. We have received tremendous support and recognition from members alongside with WISIS forums. In 2017, ITU launched a new platform led by TSB, AI for Good Global Events, with various private communities collaborating with 38 UN sister organizations and working together with BR and BDT to demonstrate One ITU. AI is one of the promising technology tools for positive influence on all 17 goals of SDGs. AI for Good is a well-known international open platform for collaboration for all stakeholders through matchmaking among problem owners and the challengers for solving those problems. With those valuable experiences, I am confident that I will be able to help build a trusted open platform by inviting experts, curating programs, and encouraging collaboration in the coming years. ICTs are being developed faster than expected. 5G is already with us, and AI with big data, IoTs, is influencing our daily lives more profoundly, leading to digital transformation, which is becoming the mainstream for innovating our society. Therefore, ICT is an essential part of our lives, and the people, organizations rely more heavily on ICTs. The COVID-19 pandemic is one of the most pressing challenges of our time. However, ironically, the COVID-19 pandemic has highlighted the critical importance of ICTs, telecommunication infrastructures, and services. Can you imagine the world without communication technology during and after this pandemic? And can you imagine maintaining our normal daily lives like we are doing now without ICTs? ICT infrastructures are not yet reaching everywhere, considering half of the world population is still not connected. And some ICT services are still too difficult for many people, particularly the aged and those who need special assistance. Moreover, ICTs are also a part of concerns and risks due to fake news, misbehavior online, digital gaps, generation gaps, security, privacy, trust, and safety issues. Therefore, I'm sure that use of reliable ICTs and access to trustworthy information are essential requirements for human life. So building a dedicated environment based on reliable ICT infrastructures and services is of utmost importance for social and economic development of the world today and beyond. And ITU shall address this as a UN specialized organization for ICT development. Therefore, building a trusted ICT platform is a key element in my vision for ICTs and the future of ITU. We are seeing a rapid individualization of our society, where the value of community has relatively weakened its importance. However, recently, building a sustainable society and addressing environmental issues have become a key topic of our time. So restoring our ability to work together to achieve our common goals is being emphasized. And in this regard, the importance of trust is being recognized as a critical element. Nowadays, ICT development enables us to meet face-to-face online, in other words, an on-tech life. The value of trust is becoming ever more critical. And more recently, this topic of trust has become more than a concept and is being increasingly accepted in the engineering sector as well. My vision as a candidate for Deputy Secretary General is building a trusted ICT platform to innovate the ITU. Let me take a moment to share my strategic approaches to achieving this vision. First, I will navigate ITU's contribution to building a resilient global ICT ecosystem and act as a bridge for harmonizing ITU members, including other international organizations, industries, academia, civil society, and others. Second, I will continuously upgrade the core competence of ITU's in-house capabilities as a specialized organization for ICTs, such as investigating advanced processes and upgrading the capacity of the General Secretariat for better productivity, efficiency, effectiveness, integrity, and accountability. Last but not least, I will enhance collaboration with and among the three bureaus and the respective directors to maximize and systemize the synergy of various ITU activities to strengthen one ITU. My first attendance at ITU was back in 1987 as a general participant. For over 27 years, I contributed continuously to the work of ITU as an editor, rapporteur, working party chair, focus group chair, and study groups vice chair and chair. and I have been serving as the director of TSB since the 2014 Plenipotentiary Conference. Altogether, for 34 years, I have enriched my knowledge of technology, market trends, members' various needs, and ITU's working methods and procedures. I believe such diverse experiences are vital in successfully carrying out the role of the Deputy Secretary General. ITU is a member states-based UN specialized agency for ICTs and a unique UN organization with members from private sectors. Today, ITU members represent the multi-stakeholder model with 193 member states, over 800 industry members, more than 150 academic members, and many civil societies. ITU has a long and proud history built on the operational principle of contribution-driven and consensus-based. ITU members believe that this spirit is a fundamental framework for such multi-stakeholder organizations, and I agree. Moreover, I firmly believe that this spirit is essential for building trusted relationships, which requires mutual understanding and patience. One crucial role of the Deputy Secretary General is to navigate and bridge among member states, between member states and sector members, between ITU and other organizations, between the Secretary General and Bureau Directors. I can assure you that my navigation capabilities based on techno-managerial expertise and bridging abilities learned as the TSB Director will help me effectively carry out such an important role. ICTs are developing faster than expected, and our lives are relying on ICTs more than ever. Therefore, building a trusted ICT platform is a fundamental and essential issue for social safety matters of the public. I would be deeply grateful to receive your support for innovating the International Telecommunication Union as the international trusted union. I'm sure my dynamic professional experiences will contribute to innovating ITU and the strengthening collaborations, which are the vital roles of the Deputy Secretary General. Lastly, I'd like to thank the Republic of Korea for the trust in nominating me as a candidate for Deputy Secretary General. I look forward to meeting you all at the coming Plenipotentiary Conference 2022 in Bucharest, Romania. Thank you and see you soon.